May 28, 2008, we had a conversation in Denver, Colorado, and you told me the following, and I'm going to quote you. What I can guarantee is that we will have, in the first year, an immigration bill that I strongly support. I want to emphasize, the first year. At the beginning of your government, you had control of both chambers of Congress. And yet you did not introduce immigration reform. Before I continue, I want for you to acknowledge that you did not keep your promise.
Well, let me first of all, Jorge, make a point that when we talked about immigration reform in the first year, that's before the economy was on the verge of collapse. Lehman Brothers had collapsed. The stock market was collapsing. And so my first priority was making sure that we prevented us from going into a Great Depression. And I think everybody here remembers where we were 4 years ago. We lost 800,000 jobs the month that I took office. Small businesses and big businesses couldn't get financing. People had seen their 401ks evaporate. People were losing homes left and right. And so we had to take a whole series of emergency actions to make sure that we put people back to work, cutting taxes for middle-class families and small businesses so that they could stay open or pay the bills, making sure that states got assistance so they didn't have to lay off teachers and firefighters and police officers, saving an auto industry that was on the brink of collapse. Took up a huge amount of time in the first year, but even in that first year, one of my first acts was to invite every single member of Congress who had previously been supportive of comprehensive immigration reform and to say to them, we need to get this done. This is something I believe in deeply because we are a nation of laws and we're a nation of immigrants. And I am willing to work with anybody to strengthen our border security and to crack down on employers who are taking advantage of undocumented workers. But what we also have to do is provide a pathway for all those millions of hardworking people who are simply here looking after their families and oftentimes have put deep roots in this country. And what I confess I did not expect, and so I'm happy to take responsibility for being naive here, is that Republicans who had previously supported comprehensive immigration reform, my opponent in 2008, who had been a champion of it, and who attended these meetings, suddenly would walk away. That's what I did not anticipate. And as you know, Jorge, even though we controlled the House of Representatives, even though we had a majority in the Senate, the way the Senate operates was if you couldn't get 60 votes, you couldn't get something moving. So we initiated the meetings, had a series of meetings, and what we could not get was a single Republican, including the 20 who had previously voted for comprehensive immigration reform, to step up and say, we will work with you to make this happen.
It was your promise, Mr. President. I am going to say